In this lecture, we are going to discuss about compensation and charge neutrality in a semiconductor. So first let me start from compensation. What is compensation? So a compensated semiconductor is one that contains both donor and acceptor impurity atom. Impurity atoms in the same region. So if we talk about a normal n-type or p-type semiconductor, we know that for a n-type semiconductor we add some donor impurities, and for p-type semiconductor we add some acceptor impurities. But in a compensated semiconductor we add both acceptors and donors. So we know that in a normal semiconductor, if there are nd donors and if n naught is the number of free electrons or electrons in conduction band, then we simply assume that n naught is equal to nd. Sometimes we use nd plus, but here I am using nd. So this is the condition for a normal semiconductor. For n-type semiconductor, and for a p-type semiconductor we know that na is the number of acceptors, and if P naught is the number of holes in valence band, then we simply assume that at a particular temperature P naught is equal to Na. So this is the condition for P type semiconductor. But for a compensated n-type material, here I am using the normal n-type semiconductor, normal p-type semiconductor. But for a compensated n-type semiconductor, compensated n-type semiconductor, there are donors and as well as acceptors. But condition here is that nd is always larger in amount than na. So if in a compensated semiconductor, if nd, that is the number of donor atoms, is always higher than the number of acceptor atoms, and here n naught, that is number of free electrons is equal to ND minus NA. So in normal semiconductor, N naught or number of free electrons can be equal to the ND, but here number of free electrons is equal to the ND minus NA, that is the difference between the donor atoms and acceptor atoms. So this is the condition for N type compensated N-type compensated semiconductor. And similarly, for P-type compensated semiconductor, NA is greater than ND. Simply, we can assume or we can see that if the semiconductor is P-type, then obviously NA is larger than the ND. And in a similar manner, we can say that P naught, that is the number of holes, is equal to NA minus ND. So this is the condition for P type compensated semiconductor. But we can think here that what will be happened when ND is equal to NA, that is if there is ND equal to NA, then we have a completely compensated semiconductor. Which behaves like an intrinsic semiconductor. So simply here meaning is that when there is only acceptor or donors are present in a semiconductor, then we call them N-type semiconductor or P-type semiconductor. But it is also possible that we can make an N-type semiconductor to P-type. That is, if there is an N-type semiconductor, then we can add acceptors in that N-type semiconductor. And at that time, when number of acceptors are greater than the number of donors, then that material will convert from N-type to P-type. It is also possible that number of acceptor is equal to the number of donors. So at that point, we can say that this semiconductor is completely compensated, and this semiconductor can behave like a pure semiconductor or intrinsic semiconductor. But some properties are very different from an intrinsic semiconductor, because here now we are adding some impurity atoms in that. So we can also see these compensation states by using energy Venn diagram. So here I am drawing a energy Venn diagram for a completely compensated semiconductor. We know that this is maximum of the valence band and this is minimum of the conduction band, and in middle of these two we have Fermi level EFI, that is for pure or intrinsic semiconductor. But here we are using a completely compensated semiconductor, so we have to add donor atoms that have energy states near to the conduction band, and at the same time there are acceptors that we have added to this semiconductor which have their energy states near to the let me make it more thicker, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like that for our convenience. Like that. So we know that due to thermal energy or due to getting of thermal energy, electrons can, and we know that this state is ED and this state is EA, that is energy state for acceptor and energy stored for donor atoms. So due to gaining of thermal energy, some electrons can go in the conduction band. Let's say 3 electrons are going from donor level to conduction band by getting some energy, and we are calling these electrons as thermal electrons. And at the same time, corresponding to these thermal electrons, we can find in valence band some holes. Since electrons are getting energy by the rising of temperature and going from valence band to conduction band, so we call these electrons as thermal electrons. So if there are 3 electrons in the conduction band, at the same time there will be 3 holes which are thermal holes in the conduction band. Thermal holes. So some electrons from these donor states can also go to the conduction band, let's say 1, 2, 3, these two electrons, or let's say three electrons, these three electrons are going from donors to the conduction band. So we can call these electrons as donor electrons. And since three electrons are going from donor states to conduction band, so we can find there are three holes in the donor states. And these states, we can say that these are the unionized donors, because electrons are still binding to these electrons, these donors, sorry. And at the same time, it is also possible, let me make here two states, it is also possible that these donor electrons can go to acceptor levels, or in other words we can say that these electrons from the donor states can be attracted by the acceptor states. So let's say these two electrons are captured by these acceptor states. So in this way we get a positive charge here, positive charge here, and negative charge due to electrons here. Since these are acceptor levels and their tendency is to absorbing the electrons from the valence band, so at the same times some states can also attract electrons from valence band. Let's say there are three electrons that are coming from the valence band, so corresponding to these three electrons there are three holes. So these holes are acceptor holes. These are donor electrons and these are acceptor holes. And here we can say that we can simply use the equation that N naught equal to ND minus NA, and here P naught equal to NA minus ND. And in other words, we can also write that NA plus, which is equal to NA minus ND. And here we can say that NA minus, or here ND plus, sorry, ND plus. And here should be ND minus, here small ND. I will define what is this ND. And here NA minus, which is equal to NA minus PA. and here n naught is the total electron concentration. That is the total holes, total electrons coming from these donor states and from the valence band. And similarly, let's say P naught is the total holes concentration. And here ND is the number of electrons or concentration of electrons in the donor energy states. Here ND we can simply say that the number of unionized donors. So ionized donors we can simply write by subtracting the number of unionized donor from the total number of donors, and at the same time PA is the number of holes in the holes in the acceptor states, or simply we can say that PA is the concentration of the unionized acceptor atoms. Simply meaning here is that this is a completely compensated semiconductors where the number of electrons and number of holes are equal in amount. Some holes are coming from directly from the acceptor levels and some are due to thermal agitation of the electrons. Similarly, we have some electrons due to getting their thermal energy, and there are some electrons that are contributed by the donor atoms. So this is a completely compensated semiconductor. And if we want to, we know that for mass action formula P naught N naught always equal to Ni square. So we can also apply this formula to getting the number of electrons or number of holes. So this is all about compensation or compensated semiconductors. That is a compensated semiconductor. If it is n-type, then in that semiconductor there are donors as well as acceptors. But for an n-type compensated semiconductor, number of donors are always greater than the number of acceptors. And for a p-type compensated semiconductors, acceptors are always greater in amount than the donors. But for a completely compensated semiconductors, number of donors are always equal to the number of acceptors. So now let's move to this charge neutrality. And we all know about what is charge neutrality. Just let me define in its semiconductor. So charge neutrality occurs when all the charges or all the charges in a volume adds to zero. That is, it is neutral, that is neither positive nor negative in charge. Similarly, in a semiconductor, the source or the sources of charge, we know that in a semiconductor, the sources of charges may be electrons or holes or acceptors or donors. Sources of charges are electrons, holes, ionized donors, and ionized acceptor atoms. So in this way we can see there are four types of charge sources from where we can get charges in a semiconductor, that is from electrons, from holes, ionized acceptor and ionized donors. If we know that if we have a n-type semiconductor, then electrically it's neutral, because since it's n-type materials, it means that number of electrons is greater than the number of holes. But as a whole, the total charge on this semiconductor is zero, since it's electrically neutral, because here number of positive charges or the and number of negative charges are equal. And at the same time, if there is a p-type semiconductor, then it's electrically neutral as a whole. Obviously, there are number of holes that are greater in amount than electrons, but as a whole, it's a neutral. So, meaning here is that the zero net charge does not mean that the electrons holes ionized donors and acceptors ionized donors and ionized acceptors are not present in the semiconductor. As I said earlier, it simply means that in a uniformly doped semiconductor, the negative charge associated with electron or ionized acceptors would be cancelled by the positive charge associated with a hole or ionized donor or donors. A neutral semiconductor or a n-type semiconductor or p-type semiconductor that is acting neutral as a hole simply means that number of holes plus ionized donor atoms always equal to the number of electrons plus ionized acceptor atoms. So this is the meaning of the neutrality. And in another way, we can also write it as the P naught minus N naught plus N D plus minus N A minus is equal to zero. And as I said earlier, P naught N naught equal to Ni zero. So we can use this equation to know the number of free electrons or number of holes in a p-type and number of electrons in n-type material. In that case, we just know the exact value of Nd, then we can get the number of electrons, and if you know the number of acceptor, then we can get the number of electrons or number of holes like this. So this is all about charge neutrality. So in this lecture, we saw the what are compensated semiconductors, what is a completely compensated semiconductor, what is an n-type compensated semiconductor, what is a p-type compensated semiconductor, and then we saw the what is charge neutrality.